welcoming you for Monkeys Monday. This is the second episode, and here we have Shanta. Shanta is a well-known technology evangelist in Chennai, SharePoint, especially in Office 365 and SharePoint area. And today he is going to teach us how to create SPFx web parts using Microsoft Graph Toolkit. So let's welcome Shanta. Shanta, it's all about yours.
Okay. Thank you, Sadis. Yeah, welcome everyone. Myself, Shanta Kumar. I'm a Microsoft Workspace consultant, and I have 10 years of experience, and I'm a CSOC Corner MEP. So, and I have a lot to talk about the SharePoint framework with Microsoft Graph Toolkit. So we are going to build a very great web port using Microsoft Graph Toolkit with less number of code. You can catch me on any social media in the name of KTS Kumar. So first, we are going to create a simple SharePoint framework web port, and in the web port, we are going to use Microsoft Graph Toolkit because it has some few components, that is predefined components, which will help us to get the data from Office 365 using the Microsoft Graph API. The Graph Toolkit, which has the capability to call the Microsoft Graph API. Okay, we'll see in action now. First, we'll create a SharePoint framework web part. So for that, I'm just create a new folder now, SPFx. MGT, this MGT is nothing but Microsoft Graph Toolkit and Monkey Demo. Okay, so then MGT, okay, create, called a Yeoman generator to generate the SharePoint framework project. So it will take some few seconds to generate. Okay. In the meanwhile, we'll also see about what is Microsoft Graph Toolkit and what are the predefined components available by default. So let me open this. Okay, you can see this is a toolkit overview or documentation from Microsoft. Here we can see what is Microsoft Graph Toolkit. This Microsoft Graph Toolkit is nothing but it has some components that used to fetch a lot of data, because the Office 365 has a lot of data in the cloud, so in the for the organization. So if you want to retrieve any data across the organization, we can use the Microsoft Graph API. So this component helps us to fetch the data in a single line of element. That is, you can use this HTML element, and by using that you can fetch the data from the Office 365. You can see this MGT agenda, which fetch all the events for a particular user, for a current user. Okay, let's back to here. Oh, stick. Okay, so we'll create, and then we'll use the SharePoint online, and then use the current folder. Okay, and then just give no. Then no, we are going to create a SPFx web part, and then select the web part. Just give the name here, okay? X Monkey SPFx MGT. Okay, and then just enter. And we are going to use the no JavaScript framework. Even though we can use the React also to generate a web component, but we are going to select the no JavaScript framework now. So it will take some couple of minutes to generate the entire package. Okay. So in the meanwhile, we'll see what are the components available. You can see these are the predefined components available: login, person, people, agenda, tasks, people picker, person code, get, and channel picker, team channel picker. We'll see everything in action. We have to just add a single element, and it will fetch the data from the Office 365. Okay. And then we'll have the providers. We can use this Microsoft Graph Toolkit from any application. So if you want to fetch the data in the SharePoint, you have to use a SharePoint provider. If you want to use this Graph Toolkit in a Teams, we have to use the Microsoft Teams provider. And if you want to fetch from any other application, we can have different providers. So even though we can customize the provider and then use the custom provider option. Okay. After that, we have the two components, that is styling component and templating component. Each element has its own properties. Okay. So this, you can see this MGT person, we can just have its own property, styling property. We can use this styling property to style that particular web component. Also, if we can have the templating components, mostly because the web component from the Microsoft Graph Toolkit, which renders it by default, it renders the output. So if you want to customize that default render, we can use the template element and then have our own div or own span tags and then fetch the data and show it. The customizing that the out of box the template. Okay, so we'll see everything in action. So it's a very simple. I hope still the framework report is running. Still is generating the package. Okay, in the meanwhile, we'll explore other things like login. If you want to use the WebCom Graph Toolkit in apart from the SharePoint framework, so we have to use the login element. This login element, which allow us to just redirect fetch access token and redirect to the current page, that application page. So it all the authentication or access token, which will be taken care by using this login element. So and then I have already created some of the SharePoint framework this report here. You can see it here. This is I have created a SharePoint framework report with simple webcam toolkit. So this is a people picker. So and then this is all groups. I have used a simple just MGT get to fetch all the SharePoint group from the Office 365. So and then this is another one example. You can see this is a simple, just only the simple few HTML code and some CSS. So which brings this the look and feel. You can see here, okay. And then another one is this will return this SharePoint framework report, which returns all the SharePoint groups with the members, who are the members available under that particular SharePoint that is Office 365 group. So we are going to see, so that is by default it show all users. Just click on get members, you can see all the members available under the Office 365. So and then if you use some group, Office 365 group, it will display only that particular Office 365 group. So if you want to see the particular user is if you want to view the groups associated to this user, you can just click on it. It will show up. Let me dismiss this. You can see these are the groups the current user is present. So we are going to do the same report in action now. So I hope the framework report is created. Still running. Yeah. Done. Let's open the code, Visual Studio Code now. Okay, so to add a Microsoft Graph Toolkit, we have to install a package at Microsoft/MGT. If you go to get started in the documentation, we can see this package we have to install. Okay, so npm I at Microsoft/MGT. So this will install the package to our code. Okay, the package is installed. So the current package is MGT 1.3.2 preview version. You can see that in package.json. Okay, so if we can just compile it and check whether the current is working or not. For.gulp. So okay, before that we have to add, we have to just import the providers to our web part, the graph toolkit providers. So import provider, I think providers, SharePoint provider from Microsoft FrameGT. Okay, and then we have to initialize this provider in our web part. Protected on init, then providers dot global provider, and then you have to initialize the SharePoint provider with the current context. Okay, this is done. So once this is done, we can use the Microsoft Graph Toolkit in our web part. So I'm just removing thing. So going to use some simple person web component. So query me. So this will return the current user picture. So if you want to show the name, just show name attribute, add a show name attribute. It is person. Okay. Save it and then run the gulp serve. Okay, so I'm open the workbench here, SharePoint workbench, because this is fetching the live data, so we have to use the SharePoint workbench. If you go with the local workbench, it won't work. Okay, so and then if we run that gulp serve, we'll face some issue because the Microsoft, the current Microsoft Graph Toolkit, which is built in the TypeScript 3.7, but our SharePoint framework compiler, which runs in the 3.3, so we have to just upgrade this compiler to run the SharePoint framework in 3.7 version. You can see the TypeScript version is 3.3. Okay, so we'll get the error. So to fix this, we have to install one more package. That is, close this, npm install dev. Just copy this 3.7, enter. So now it will install the upgrade package, the compiler package, TypeScript compiler package to our SharePoint framework web part. Yeah, our package is installed here. So we can just remove it, but we can uninstall this 3.3 compiler and do it. But at present, I'm not going to do that. So it will take more time due to the network issue. So I'm going to use this 3.7, the TS config, just change it to 3.7 and then save. Okay, now if we run the gulp serve, it won't return a error. It will just give a warning because by default the SharePoint framework, we have to use the 2.9 some TypeScript thing. So leave this. This is not an issue. Okay, now it's compiled. You can see the TypeScript version is 3.7.5. Yeah, loaded. I will check here in our X. Yeah, you can see this is a local host, so that it's not working now in this page. Search for our report. You can see the current user image and then the name. Let's move back to our code. Okay, so each one, because and then if you want to test with the other query, you can just check. You can test it from Graph Explorer. So because we are going to use the MGT get, that is, in if you are using the MGT get component, we have to specify our graph query there. Instead of just login and then signing in, you can see I'm just going to retrieve all the users from the Office 365 environment. So this is the query I'm going to use, the slash users. For that, here, so before jumping to that, we'll try all the web components in a single thing itself. That is MGT person already we tried, and the MGT people, maybe we can try it all. Okay, that is, save it. It will compile, it will take some time. You can see this is the MGT people, this is the +5. You can see this is the MGT people component, and this is MGT person. If you hover, you can see the image. So this is what this MGT person, surname, email, and then this is person code. You can see the hovering, this is a person code component, and then the people picker. Here we can just type select any members, like, yeah, this is a people picker component, and it fetch all the info user. You can just type it, and then you can get all the users from the Office 365 environment based on the search query. So, and then team channel picker. So teams, all the teams available here, and then if you expand this, you can see the channels, and then the agenda. So this will return all the events, the upcoming events in particular this component, MGT agenda. And then the MGT task, which returns all the tasks from the planner and to-do component in the Office 365. Okay, these are all the components. We can just, if you want to re-render or if you want to customize this component, that is also, we can do it by using the embedding the template component within each element. Okay, so I'm just going to remove everything. So here I'm going to use we are going to retrieve all the users from the Office 365 environment. So get resource, you can see in the Graph Explorer what we have used, the slash users, the version v1.0. And then the permissions. So here, the modify permissions, that is, we have to use the scope. So if you want to retrieve all the users from the Office 365 environment, just use scopes equal to users dot z dot all. Okay, and then slash get. So if you want to retrieve, this will retrieve the user information, but we have to render the output. For that, we have to use the template component. Template. Okay, there are three template types are there, that is data type default, and another one is loading, and another one is error. If you want to show some text whenever the loading purpose, you can use the data type loading. So, but I'm not going to do that now. So, because we are having the less number of data, so it won't show up there. Templating, and then I'm going to use UL component. So, and then data for, because this returns, the template returns in a JSON format, and in a values in an array. So, we have to use user in value, because the JSON format returns all the values in the all the output in a value variable. And then li, so here just user dot display name, save it, and then wait for the compile to render. Okay, then we'll go to SharePoint framework report, the first page. You can see these are the users available in the Office 365. So let's jump into our code. Okay, so now we get all the data, but we want to show in a nice look and feel, nicer look and feel. So for that, I have selected and I have taken a code pen as an example, this project from the code pen. So we are going to just show as same as it is in our SharePoint framework. So here I have taken maybe just HTML, just copy it, and then maybe remove the remaining div. Okay, so this is a sample HTML. So we have to copy the class also from here, the styles CSS. But I have already stored this CSS in one simple CSS style sheet file. So I'm going to just call this here. I'm calling here link. Okay. Site asserts. I have stored in the site asserts library. Oh, CSS. Okay, and then I have stored here. Just save it on the first page. Okay, run. Okay. Package is done. It's reloading. Just refresh. You can see this. Now we are going to have all the outputs in this box type. So for that, let's go here and then just bring this into our template component. Okay. So above that, we have to add gallery, because in that sample we have given this. So here we are going to use data for user in value. And then here instead of this image, we are going to replace with MGT person query equal to user dot display name, or we can use the mail property also here. So and then here the same user dot display name. User dot mail. User dot. Maybe I think here we can use the job given name. We'll check what are the outputs we have retrieved in the Graph Explorer. So run query. You can see the display name, given name, job title, mail, and everything is coming here. So I'm going to use given name and job title. So given name, so dot job title. Save it. Run the report. I think it's read render is not completed. Okay, reloaded. So I think there isn't some issue, I hope. Value is not a valid attribute. Okay. We haven't closed this. Save it. Okay. It's compiling, it's taking first page. Still having the problem. Problem with template data type default gallery user in value container.
Shanta.
Yeah.
In line number 33.
Okay. Check that okay. Once. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. So it's very okay. Compile.
Shanta, still we have an exception. I think we need to look at some other place. Yep.
No, I think we got it. Okay. So here you can see, if you want to just do the responsive, we have to just update in the CSS. Okay. Now I think it's look fine. So because here you can see these are trying to retrieve the user images. So the user image is not available, so that it's because for all the users it tries the graph component, the kit itself try to retrieve the images. So we are not writing any code and all for retrieving the user images. So everything is inbuilt in the web component. So it's trying to fetch it and it's not having that image, so that it's by default it's rendered as a with the name. Okay, so let's close this. So if you want to just try it in a modern page, that's also possible. So I'm going to create the same, instead of trying it in a workbench, we can try it in a modern page itself. So if we try it in a modern page, that will be a very good one for test, because we can test directly in the modern page how it look like that one. So create a page that is maybe Monkey Monday SPFX. Okay, then so save it, and then I'm going to run this as a maybe I have this load SPFX parameter and debug to this manifest. This is a manifest JS is coming from the SharePoint framework, the local workbench. Okay, just render it. So, and then here load debug scripts, click on that and edit the page. You can just get, can see it here. So we can test directly from the modern page itself, instead of doing it in a workbench. All the users available here. So now we'll try to fetch all the teams, all the groups available in the Office 365 and show it in a drop down. Once the based on the selection of the group, we'll be showing the user. For that, just go to our code. Here we are going to add a drop down. So I already have this snippet here. I'm going to use the MGT get and then slash groups. So if you try it in a graph explorer, you can see all the groups available here. Just run query and then you can see. So the scope, whatever we are specifying, it's already available. Already the, I have given the permission to the scopes, that is it's available in So this scope, here previously we have given the user.read.all, this is scope.read.all. We have to specify all the permissions required. We have to give in the package.solution under the web manifest here. You can see we have to give in this package solution under the web API permission request. Save it. So I have already given this kind of permission in another SharePoint framework report, so that it's by default it's fetching the data. So otherwise it will return you the access denied. So I'm going to new version of admin and then advanced API access. Here you can see the permissions I have given to the scope. This group.read.all I have already given, and then user.read.all. So even though if you are not, because if you are trying with the Microsoft Graph Toolkit, so before trying before the install packet, because if we deploy this packet, then only this permissions will get populated here. If you want to populate before that, you have to go to the Microsoft Azure portal, there app registrations. Here you can see one called SharePoint Online Client Extensibility Web Application Principle. Here go to API permissions. Here you can directly give here. So if you give the permissions here, by default it available in the show it in the admin center. Okay, so if you want to, if you are not able to go to this instead of adding permission, if you give the scope here itself and then try it in a SharePoint, by default this permission is added to this app registration here, and then you have to provide a concern, upload a concern from this configure permissions page. So this is the hack to just for the developers to try before deploy the SharePoint package. Okay, now I have used this MGT get group and then group.read.all permission, and then in the select element I am populating all the group members, and also I have all users as a by default. So saved it, and then it's reloaded, and then I am going to try it in a page. So now you see all the groups available here. Okay, so if you want to just select it and try it, I'm going to add another button here to fetch the data. Okay, once I click on this get members button, it will fetch all the groups, all the members available from the group, and then show it here. For that I'm going to add one. So here you can see the button get members. Clicking on the button get members button, it will fetch the get members or it will call the get members co function. So this calls the get members. In the get members I am fetching the selected group ID. Okay, because here you can see in the value I have added a group ID. So it fetches the group ID, and then it's pass that group ID into generate members. So here I am just calling this MGT people web component, and I have also added a template to show the persons. So just saving it here, and then we'll wait for to compile. So this is now done, and then just refresh the page, reload. Okay, so I'm going to select modern site get members. I think there's some problem, right? So I'm just publish this. I think it's written some error, right? I think it's not calling. Oh, okay. I forgot to. We have to just call this method, because if you call this method, then only this it will bind the click event to this button get members. So this dot. Okay. Once this is done, we'll see that in action. So okay. Now we'll. So you. Okay. It's done. We'll check. Okay. Just click on this get members. You can see the members available. So we have used only the to show the picture, so that it's showing only the picture of that members from the M365 bootcamp. But I'm going to show as I am as it is all users. So replacing this with another code. Here you can see the code image container same which I've used earlier. So okay, this template I've used. And then because here if you are using the users slash users, it will return the output in the value. But if you use the MGT people, the output which returns in the people. So I've used the if by ID. So in here, to select all users, I have used the minus one for the all users option. So if group ID is minus one, I'm going to render this users, all users. If group ID is greater than minus one, I'm passing this group ID into here MGT people component and then show it here, the template. This is the template. Save it. And then just we have to remove this particular component. We have to just remove it. Save. Okay. This is still in compile. Packaging and reloaded, right? First page, get members. Just click on this get members. You can see all the users. So if we select something talent manager group, so it returns some few members. So maybe ktskuma.com demo. You can see only the 6 members. So it's based on the group. It returns the value here. Okay. So now boom back to our code. Now we are going to have to add a new user to the group. So that is not possible with Office Microsoft Graph Toolkit. For that we are going to call the Microsoft Graph API to add a user. Okay. So I'm going to add one more people picker control here and then adding one more button called a button add name. Once the user is selected a people from the people picker control and then user click the button add member button, it will add that particular user to the selected group. Okay, so for that we have to just update the code, add the event handler to this button add name. So we have added this MGT people picker is maybe this we can just fetch it from the Microsoft MGT. So this is the MGT people picker element. Yeah, we have added here, right? So once this is done, it's getting the value from MGT people picker and then also getting the value from the selection element. So once this is done, it's added, it's because this generate the JSON for the body. Okay. And that added the user ID and then here passing that group ID here and then the user ID here. So save it. Just refer. Okay, we'll wait for the compile. Refers. Okay, all users get members. Okay, I'm trying to get modern site group. Only 3 members. Maybe here I select Sadis. Add member. You can see the user is added and you can also see it here. You want to check it once again. You can get from see this is done. So this is very simple. And another one functionality we are trying to add here, once I click on this it will open a panel and show the groups the user is associated with. Okay, just go back to the code. Here, the template, I think. Here I have used a show panel, the function. Okay, so I'm going to add this show panel function. Instead of adding it in a separate function here, I'm going to add it, insert it in the HTML itself. Here I have added a show panel, and then these are the element ID we have used for showing the members, and then this is for showing the panel and right. So we haven't added a HTML for panel. We are going to add it right now. So this is the panel. Once this panel is right, we have used a MGT component and then showing all the groups the account user is associated with. So this one, this we haven't used the resource here. Instead of resource, I am using that in here in the show panel, the set attribute MGT group. This is the MGT group, setting the attribute users, user ID, passing the user ID and then the member of. So this is the slash users, user ID and member of, which returns to the groups the current user is associated. Just save it and then go back to compiler. It's still running. Refresh it. All users, just select maybe my name. You can see the panel is showing here. Okay, so I have injected the JavaScript in this place. So here I used a new script, created a script element, because if you used directly the script element in the HTML, it won't work because the modern page won't allow it. So for that, I have created a separate create element and injected into the DOM, this DOM element. So the script and then the append child, and then here this is what have done it. Okay, so this, by using the same kind of thing, we can generate a lot of SPFX reports with different graph API endpoints. Okay, but if you want to use the multiple, because if you want to generate a different, we have to create a number of SharePoint framework web parts to use the graph toolkit for different functionalities. So I have created a separate web part called, once again, I have opened it. So MGT editor web part. So here have used two properties here, HTML code and JS code as a SharePoint framework web part property. And I have used a PNP field controls. So this will open that Visual Studio, that's HTML code editor here in the web part property. And then I have used that HTML code and JS code and embed in the SharePoint framework web part. So I'll show you that. So go back to my MGT here. You can, so maybe here, this one, just edit and then here edit. You can see all the, I think this look, I have used that HTML component, HTML elements here itself. You can see this will return to the all the list from the root site of the Office 365, that SharePoint. So I have used the scope and everything here in the here itself, in the web part property itself, and then added the HTML element within the template, the loading error, and then CSS also have used here itself. Save it. And then the JavaScript, if you want to embed or inject any JavaScript functionality here, you can use this particular component and save it. That's it. So we can use a single SharePoint framework web part for multiple SPFX functionalities. So the same, this also the same have used. You can see this returns all the SharePoint, all the Office 365 group which is enabled with the Teams. So So this is simple. Okay, this is a CSS. If we can also add a CSS to nice functionality here. Okay, so if you want to test with some other thing, maybe I'll create one more page here. New site page. Just MGT. Add graph toolkit. This header, maybe we can test it from MGT dev. Here, this is a storybook from the Microsoft Graph Toolkit. Here we can try it out, multiple web component. Here we can try it anything. So, okay. So, just I'm going to maybe this one. Select even changed. Also, get selected channel. Okay. Okay, this functionality I'm trying to just copy this HTML, edit, save it. Okay, and then the CS JS, just copy it. Save it. Publish. So general git select channel, right? So these are the, so instead of that we can use this option to show the members available in this particular team or particular channel also possible. This is a very simple. So what are the features, what are the I have used the same, we can just copy this HTML into this Microsoft Graph Editor and just we can also get the same functionality except the add feature, because the add feature only we have to use the Office that is Graph API for posting that. So only this Microsoft Graph Toolkit component which helps us to retrieve the fetched information, fetch the data from the Office 365. Okay, so these are all available in my GitHub. You can use this Microsoft Graph Editor web part. You can just use this web part. You can use this in your environment, and then you can use you can try it out any Microsoft Graph Toolkit with any if you want to fetch any Office 365 data, you can use this web part. Yeah, any questions? Yes, sir, yes, you want to say?
Yeah, thank you, Sundar bro. We have three questions.
Yeah.
So, first, how did you find that issue? So, I mean, the compiler version issue, how do we fix those kind of things normally?
I think this takes taken some time for me to identify the particular issue. So, and then I have just gone through that Microsoft Graph Toolkit GitHub, and then I checked that the Graph Toolkit they have used the packet, the TypeScript version is 3.7. So I tried the same thing here. So initially, previously I tried with some on-premise environment. It is not for the Microsoft Graph Toolkit. The SharePoint framework which doesn't work with for SharePoint 2016. It has some issue with the TypeScript compiler. So I got the same just taken my mind, and then I just changed the TypeScript compiler here, and then I find out the issue. Yeah, another question.
That's
question.
Perfect. Yeah. The next one is how are we authenticating with the SharePoint and the Graph API, Shanta?
Okay. That's what I have earlier shown this particular single line which takes us about the authentication. because we are pausing the provider because all Microsoft Graph Toolkit which authenticate using the providers. So if you go with the Teams provider, if you want to access and authenticate with Teams, we have to use the Teams provider. If you want to authenticate with AAD and some .NET Core application or the .NET application, we have to use the MSAL provider. So like that, then the SharePoint, we have to use the SharePoint provider, and then we have to pause the current user context to this SharePoint provider, so that the Graph Toolkit, which identifies and authenticates the current user to access that Graph API. So still have more queries on this. It will nicely explained in I think where here in the providers. The provider section. So for each
okay.
one, the provider this. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So the third and last question.
I think it's only two.
Okay.
No.
Do you have it?
The final question, can you explain HTML editor?
Okay. So this is the next question because, okay, I have code, go back to the code. Because here, why I go with the editor webpart, right? So here we have to create a multiple SharePoint framework webparts and then we have to deploy multiple webparts to the tenant. So for the different Graph Toolkit functionality. So to avoid that, I have created editor webpart which combines all the things. Here you can, if you compare the both webpart, here you can see all the things which goes under here, the HTML code. You can see this, the HTML, all the HTML here which goes under this, because this HTML elements I have updated in the webpart property. And to inject the JavaScript, this part. So I have used this, and then here instead of this script, I have used that this dot properties dot js code. This is come from the SharePoint framework webpart property. So all the things this comes under here. Go back to, I'm going back path page all list, and then here I have editor. Just go back to the editor, edit. I have two webpart properties. One is for HTML. I have added all SharePoint Graph Toolkit elements and HTML element here. So this will be added within the SharePoint framework element, the DOM element. Okay. And then if you want to add any JavaScript functionality here, maybe you can add some carousel, or if you want to add any more function in hover, you want to just pop up. So that kind of functionality you can add it by using embed your JavaScript here in this edit JavaScript box. So I have added this particular thing. Maybe if you want to just remove everything, and then if you want to add something like simple MJT person query me, and then show name, show presence, and then show email, right? Email or right? Save. You can see the show presence functionality, which is I think still in the some issue thing, so that we haven't received that presence here. This is simple. Only thing, we have to add a web component, or if you want to add any HTML, you can just add it here. Got it?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, Shanta. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for your time, Shanta.
Thank you.
Really, we enjoyed.
Right. Thank you, Sadhis.
Thank you.
For just giving the opportunity in Monkeys Monday to take this session. Right. Thank you, everyone.
Yeah.
So, if any queries or any issues, or if you want to discuss anything, just ping me at KDS Kumar in Twitter or LinkedIn. Thank you.